Knoxville is an incredible place to be, and you're well aware of that. We are too. This is why we choose to live here, work here, raise our families here, and support this amazing community. Because what's important to you is important to us.
We are Carrie Garcia,
Matt Kissinger,
and Adam Norris.
And we choose Knoxville.
Good evening. Welcome to the 19th Annual Knoxville Scholarship Recognition Program. My name is Tracy Wilkins, and I'm the high school principal. Tonight is one of my favorite nights of the school year. It's with great pleasure that I have the opportunity to recognize the academic accomplishments of the class of 2022. I am so impressed with the generosity of all our contributors to the scholarships awarded tonight. Prior to getting the evening started, I would like to thank several individuals that have made this evening possible. First of all, I would like to thank all of the board of directors of the Knoxville Panther Scholarship Foundation for making tonight happen. I would also like to thank Rochelle Rupke, Doug Hatch, Carolyn Jones, and Tyler Pearson for all their work with students on scholarship applications and all the time they spent behind the scenes ensuring tonight's presentation would go off without a hitch. It is now my great pleasure that I get to introduce one of our founding members and the president of the Knoxville Panther Scholarship Foundation, Mr. Court Freuden.
Members of the Knoxville High School class of 2022, parents, families, friends, and donors, and others watching this live streaming award ceremony, welcome to the 19th Annual Knoxville Panther Scholarship Foundation Award Ceremony. Although our lives have certainly been affected in many ways by the health crisis our country has experienced the past 2 years, one thing hasn't changed, seniors: the pride and joy that we feel of members of this graduating class. Your parents, family, your teachers have persevered through the most difficult of times. Be assured, your community is proud of you and all you have accomplished. This evening, we will be awarding scholarships from both the foundation and the community. In addition to the scholarships awarded by the foundation, graduating seniors will also receive scholarship awards from community organizations, churches, businesses, individuals, and family sponsors. These scholarships are awarded to students who made a separate application to each of the donors, and the donors chose the recipients. As a result, this evening, students may receive several scholarships. In the case of the foundation, students made one general application. The foundation scholarship committee then matched the students' post-secondary education goals with the specific wishes of the scholarship donors. The foundation scholarship committee then chose the recipient on behalf of their donor. Each graduating senior who applied for a scholarship will receive one tonight from the foundation. I'd like to mention one final difference. Donations for community scholarships are not tax deductible, while those to the foundation are. And that actually makes sense if you think about it. If a donor could choose a recipient and still deduct the donation, well, then every parent and grandparent would be awarding scholarships to their children and grandchildren. At this time, I would ask that if any of our donors do happen to be present tonight, would you please stand up, please, and receive recognition here from the audience. Any of our donors who happen to be present tonight. I really can't express just how grateful the board of directors is for your continued support. I know I'll probably be mentioning figures throughout my speech tonight, but I want to tell you that in 2004, we had 36 donors, and we awarded $18,500 in scholarships. Tonight, we will award scholarships to our graduating seniors and to members of the Knoxville High School graduating class of 2019, 20, and 21 for a total amount of over $160,000. A growth from $18,500 to $160,000. We will have reached tonight our total award amounts over the past 19 years will total over $1.5 million. tell you one thing about this community. If the cause is a just one, this community and our alumni are extremely generous. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank the members of our board of directors, Andy Adamczyk, Kevin Crawford, Doug Hatch, David Hoke, Chris Hoyt, Carolyn Jones, Mary Kiefer, Tyler Pearson, Dawn Rankin, Mike Roberts, and Tracy Wilkins. I can tell you the number of hours that they put in throughout the year working on behalf of you students is truly remarkable. The preparation of this awards ceremony, like Mr. Wilkins mentioned, is the work of a lot of individuals, such as Mr. Wilkins himself, Mrs. Jones, Mr. Hatch, Mr. Pearson, Rochelle Wilkie, and I'd also like to thank Mr. DeBauer tonight, who is helping us with taking photographs. By the way, students, we will have a group photograph on the stage once the ceremony is over, and parents, you are all welcome to come down and take photos at that time. I'd also like to thank Marion County Savings Bank for their help in helping prepare the printed materials for tonight's program, and for the donation of employee time throughout the year. Parents and students, please note that your scholarship award money will not be mailed to your financial aid office until the first week of July. This allows for the colleges and institutions to close their fiscal year at the end of June and not create confusion. This way, the money we send will be credited for the fall semester. Also, if you decide to change your school, the ones that you told that you were planning on going to, we will need your new student ID number and the office financial aid address in order for us to get the money to the proper place. And students, please keep in mind, we will not send money to your financial aid office until we receive a copy of the thank you letter you send to your donors. And all of that information will be in the packets that you receive tonight. Because this event is being live streamed, I would like to mention that the foundation supports not only current graduates of Knoxville High School, but also provides financial aid for our graduates during their second, third, and fourth year of post-secondary education. This year, we will be providing financial aid to 74 KHS graduates from the classes of 2019, 20, and 21 who applied for additional financial aid. Graduates, the purpose of this foundation is to help you reach your post-secondary goals. Whether you choose to attend a trade school or to work on an apprenticeship, pursue an associate's degree, or to attend a traditional four-year college or university, the foundation is here to help you to attain the training you need to prepare for a successful future. Graduates, you are eligible for a post-secondary scholarship from our foundation for up to 4 years. We take applications every year from January 1st until March 1st. It is your responsibility to apply. We are not going to be sending you a warning or an indication that you need to make an application. That's your responsibility. Again, in the information that you receive tonight, all you need to do is go to kpsfoundation.org for all the application procedures. This year, our donors will be providing the 77 members of this graduating class who apply for a foundation scholarship a total of $44,000 in financial aid. Since our foundation began in 2004, 1,481 Knoxville High School graduates have applied for financial aid, and every single one of them has received a scholarship from our foundation. Tonight, we are going to be awarding scholarships in several categories. First, I would like to mention is endowed scholarships, which are funded through earnings on a one-time donation of $15,000 or by a series of donations totaling $15,000. These donations allow us to offer endowed scholarships each year without any further contributions required. We are awarding six new endowed scholarships this year. The Kitty and Bill Shepherd Family Scholarship, the Kay and John Jensen Scholarship, the Robert and Virginia Runnels Memorial Scholarship, the the Roger and Linda Brooks Family Scholarship, the Henry and Patricia Rosenboom Family Scholarship, and the Laura Feldman Education Scholarship. We will be awarding 29 endowed scholarships this evening to members of this graduating class. An additional 28 endowed scholarships are being awarded to members of the classes of 2019, 20, and 21. We also are going to be awarding named scholarships, which are funded by annual contributions from organizations, businesses, families, and individuals. We have 5 new named scholarships this year. The Steve DeMoss Memorial Scholarship, the Lee Ewald Memorial Scholarship, the Arden Lighting Group Scholarship, the Knoxville Excellence in Education Scholarship, and the Coach John Carl Scholarship. We will be awarding 48 named scholarships to graduating seniors, an additional 75 named scholarships to members of the graduating classes of 2019, 20, and 21. Also, past graduating classes also offer scholarships known as Panther Pride Scholarships. The KHS classes of 1961, 64, 66, 71, 73, 84, and 1991 will be awarding scholarships this year. Panther Pride Scholarships are typically awarded to children or grandchildren of class members. We'll also be awarding honor scholarships, which are funded by the growth of our endowment fund, which, by the way, has grown to over $1.5 million since since we began in 2004. Finally, Crozier scholarships are funded by the Robert Lloyd and Myrtle Madge Educational Trust. 8 current members of this graduating class and 24 members of the classes of 2019, 20, and 21 will be receiving Crozier scholarships this year. The foundation also offers second, third, and fourth year scholarships. 25 members of the KHS class of 2021 will apply for a scholarship this year and will receive a second year scholarship funded by Don and Margaret Long. 51 members of the KHS classes of 2019 and 2020 will receive scholarships funded by earnings from our endowment fund and by contributions made to the foundation as part of our annual fundraising appeal. To the class of 2022, the individuals, businesses, and organizations that have donated the money you will be receiving have chosen you as their recipient. They certainly deserve your thanks and would love to hear how you are doing in the future. As I have mentioned, you will be receiving the names and addresses of your scholarship donors in the packet you will receive this evening. It would be nice if you take a minute or two after your first semester and go back to their donor and give them an update. Let them know how things are going. And for those of you following this ceremony on our live streaming platform, thank you for helping us celebrate and honor the achievements of the Knoxville High School class of 2022. Congratulations, graduates. We are proud of your accomplishments and really look forward to following your progress in the future. And I can tell you that I read every application that comes in, and I look forward to hearing from every single one of you next year. I wish you the very best as you pursue your dreams. And now, before beginning our scholarship awards, the Board of Directors would like to take a few moments to honor 3 individuals. The first is Francis Kirkley. Francis, if you could come out, please. Francis, if there's anyone in our community more beloved than you, I can't imagine who it would be. Francis has been a donor with our foundation for many years. One of her great joys is meeting and staying in touch with the students that have received the scholarship that she has awarded in the name of her husband, Larry, and her son, Tommy.
Tommy.
I'm sorry, I got that mixed up with today. Thank you for keeping me on the straight and narrow. In fact, Francis, tonight we're going to give you a chance to meet the young lady who will be receiving the Tommy Kirkwood Memorial Scholarship this year. I'd like to introduce to you Johanna Lynn. scholarship award to give to
I give this.
To give this to the man in just a moment here. You can take one of these. One other little surprise for you. Just a second here. You know, I know you like visiting with the students that you've awarded scholarships to in the past. Francis, we happen to have one of those students with us here tonight. Laura Misicic is here.
Oh, is she here?
She is here, yes. Lauren happens to have a little extra something here for you, Francis. It says, "Happy birthday, Francis. I believe August 19th you will be turning 100. If you would all join me, please, in singing Happy Birthday to Francis.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Francis. Happy birthday to you." So that was when I went into the Dollars for Scholars program. And I want to thank David Hope for giving me so much help to help guide me along this way. And I want you to know, boys and girls, this was a privilege for me to be able to do this, because it gives an old lady a purpose. And I'm so pleased to get to do it. I want you to know that. And when I give a scholarship, I don't just give you this your scholarship. I stay right with you until you graduate. I write you letters. I hope you write back to me. I ask you to come and see me once in a while, and some of them do. I've got a list of those who have. I started this in 2011. And I want to bring something to you here. Established a scholarship in your son Lily's name to one of us who received it. You called us one of your children. We have taken such good care of me in the past years, so on Mother's Day, I wanted to make sure that you received a card from one of your kids. Now, that gets you right here. It's like when I was in school. These figures will stagger you. I was born in 1922, and so I started to school when I was in 1927. When I was a kindergartner, they taught me how to print. When I was in first grade, they taught me how to write. And in school, we had what was called penmanship. And we had to practice to make sure that we knew how to write real well. When I was in high school, there was an opportunity for us. I always thought I wanted to be a country school teacher because my mom was a teacher and my two older sisters were teachers. So I took what was called normal training classes all through the 4 years of high school. And we got to go out and do a practice teaching, but this was to teach in a country school, a one-room school, so different from what you kids have now. But when you graduated from high school, you needed to be 18, you had to pass state board, and then you weren't married. That was one of the rules. You couldn't be a teacher. Well, I wasn't 18, but I was fortunate enough to get a job as a telephone operator. And I want to tell you that my salary was 30 cents an hour. Well, I went on working as a telephone operator, and I met Tommy Kirkwood, and the love bug hit me, and I never did become a school teacher. But I always worked with children. I was a den mother to the little boys for 3 years. And I want to tell you, the two of them still call me their den mother. And all 3 years, I have worked with children, and I have been pleased to work with them. And I'll be pleased to work with the ones that I get this time. And bless your heart for the girls coming tonight. I appreciate them. I guess I don't have too much more to say, but this is quite a thrill. And when Kirk called and told me, I said, I sure hope I don't get up there and mess this up. So thank you, and thank you for coming, and thank you.
Next honoree is Carolyn Jones. Carolyn, if you come up, please. Carolyn has been a member of our board. Carolyn has been a member of our board of directors since becoming one of our high school guidance counselors, I think 11 years ago, is that correct? Or 12 years ago. I tell you something, her love for her students, her desire to help each of them achieve their goals, has really truly been an inspiration. For the past 12 years, Carolyn has also organized our Community Scholarship Awards program. Her devotion to her students and to the volunteer efforts of our community has resulted in her being selected to receive this year's Governor's Volunteer Service Award. Carolyn will receive her award from the Governor in a ceremony to be held June 21st. Tonight, the foundation is awarding a scholarship in Carolyn's name to Lauren Misetich. This fall, Lauren will be attending her junior year at Iowa State University, majoring in marketing and international business. We're so pleased to have you here this evening, Lauren, and congratulations, Carolyn. And by the way, Carolyn isn't retiring from the board. She's just retiring from teaching. She has promised to return and continue to serve on the board in the years to come. Hopefully a lot of years to come. Thank you again, Carolyn. Thank you for everything you've done for us. Our final honoree tonight is Mr. David Cook. David, could you come to the stage, please? David has been on our board since the foundation was established in 2004. He recently retired from 20 plus years serving our community with Marion County Savings Bank. I can tell you that every volunteer organization in our community came to depend on Dave's expertise and his willingness to help further the growth of volunteer efforts in our community. And by the way, Dave is also a former recipient of the Governor's Volunteer Service Award. Tonight, the foundation is awarding a scholarship in Dave's name to Sam Waffle. Sam will be a senior at the University of Northern Iowa this fall, majoring in math education. Sam, we are so pleased to have you here this evening to receive this scholarship. Thank you again so much. Thank you. I'd like to remind everyone this evening that when you leave, we will have a results sheet available for you that will have all the scholarships, awards, and the students who receive them. And one other thing, we also have some cupcakes out there to help celebrate Francis's birthday, so please take a cupcake with you when you leave as well. Now I'd like to introduce, finally, Mr. Wilkins, so we can begin making the scholarship awards. Thank you, everyone, for your patience. And again, seniors, the very best. I look forward to hearing from you in the years to come.
Before we present our first scholarship tonight, I want to echo what Mr. Froyan already stated and thank all the donors for making this evening possible. Tonight, we present a scholarship. You will see the student's name and the donor's name on the slides on the screen. Thank you to Mr. Pearson, Mr. Splavik, and Mrs. McWilliams for managing technology and streaming tonight's event. As we present the awards, we invite parents and family members to feel free to come take pictures. Will you please silence your cell phones at this time? We begin tonight's program with the presentation of our first Knoxville Panther Scholarship Foundation scholarship. The Tommy Kirkwood Memorial Scholarship was awarded to Johanna Leonard. Johanna will also be receiving scholarships from the Knoxville Heritage Community Foundation, the Knoxville High School Music Boosters, and the Knoxville Rotary Club. Congratulations, Johanna. The Knoxville Raceway Scholarship is being presented to Seth Walrath. Seth is also being awarded the Beatty Tucker American Legion Scholarship and the Jim Darnell Scholarship. Congratulations, Seth. Congratulations, Chloe. A Knoxville Raceway Scholarship is being presented to Carson Irvin. Congratulations, Carson. Of the Marion County Bank Scholarship, the Robert Lloyd and Myrtle Madge Crozier Scholarship, and the Knoxville Rotary Club Scholarship. Congratulations, Joey. Alex Rothfuss is the recipient of the Joe Schwanebeck Memorial Scholarship. Congratulations, Riley. Gary Wallace Memorial Scholarship is presented to Lainey Smith. Congratulations, Lainey. Evan Frigo is the recipient of the Kincaid Family Scholarship and the Knoxville Heritage Community Foundation Scholarship. Congratulations, Evan. A Knoxville Panther Scholarship Foundation Honor Scholarship goes to Michael Owens. Congratulations, Michael. The Knoxville Alumni Association Scholarship is awarded to Andrew Jackson. Congratulations, Andrew. The Dan and Becky McKay Scholarship is awarded to Amaya Quinn. Congratulations, Amaya. Our next scholarship recipient is Olivia Payne, and she is presented the Kay and John Jensen Scholarship. Congratulations, Olivia. The Sarah Templeton Harvey Roteman Memorial Scholarship is awarded to Jaden Striegel. Jaden is also receiving a Knoxville Alumni Association in honor of John and Pat Haining Scholarship, a Baby Tucker American Legion Scholarship, and a Knoxville Elementary Schools PTO Scholarship. Congratulations, Jaden. The Lee Ewald Scholarship is awarded to Amber Yulstead. Congratulations, Amber. Taylor Jones is receiving a Knoxville Raceway Scholarship. Congratulations, Taylor. John Frasco is receiving the Mahaska Bottling Scholarship. Congratulations, John. The Beverly J. Eck Nursing Scholarship is awarded to Brooklyn Lundy. Brooklyn is also receiving the Knoxville Optimist Club Scholarship. Congratulations, Brooklyn. Paige Luddington is being awarded the Mike McKay Memorial Scholarship. Paige is also being awarded the Anonymous Donor Scholarship. Congratulations, Paige. also receiving the Beatty Tucker American Legion Scholarship, the Chase Larson Memorial Scholarship, the Knoxville Hospital and Clinics Auxiliary Scholarship, the Robert Lloyd and Myrtle Madge Crozier Scholarship, and a Knoxville Rotary Club Scholarship. Congratulations. Serenity Smith is being presented a Knoxville Panther Scholarship Foundation Honor Scholarship. Congratulations. Dr. Lisa Holst Scholarship is being awarded to Macy Northway. Congratulations. Rebecca Lischleiter is being presented a Knoxville Panther Scholarship Foundation Honor Scholarship. Congratulations. Being presented the Knoxville Panther Scholarship Foundation Honor Scholarship. Congratulations, Lauren. The Clarence Inkstrom Scholarship is being awarded to Holly Gilchrist. The Julia C. Job First Federated Study Club Scholarship goes to Lydia Mazza. Olivia is also being awarded the First Federated Study Club Scholarship, a Robert Lloyd and Myrtle Madge Crozier Scholarship, and a Knoxville Rotary Club Scholarship. Before we proceed, there were two individuals that received awards tonight that are also have something to celebrate. Olivia and Jaden, I believe, qualified for state tests. Brent and Shirley Traver Family Scholarship is being presented to Regan Barrett. The Pell Roll Screen Foundation Scholarship is being awarded to Ethan Dursley. Congratulations, Ethan. Braden Babbitt is being presented with the Dr. Dick Young and Dr. Travis Egestall Scholarship. Congratulations, Braden. McKenna Wills is being presented with the Knoxville Panthers Scholarship Foundation Honor Scholarship and a Carolyn Miller Memorial Scholarship. Unfortunately, McKenna wasn't able to attend this evening. Abby Lee is presented with the Greg Witzman Scholarship. Congratulations, Abby. The Kevin and Jennifer Wadley Scholarship goes to Kira Deaver. Recipient is Grant Liston. He is being awarded the Ardent Lighting LLC Scholarship. Edna and Carol Johnson and Family Scholarship is awarded to Maya Carmona. Is also being awarded the Beverly J. Eck Nursing Scholarship, the Robert Lloyd and Myrtle Madge Crozier Scholarship, and a Knoxville Rotary Club Health Care Scholarship. Congratulations, Mom. The Tom and Lori Bailey Scholarship goes to Tristan Frost. Unfortunately, Tristan was unable to be here tonight. The Terry Triplett Memorial Scholarship goes to Emmett Schmidt. Emmett is also being awarded a Knoxville High School Music Booster Scholarship and the Robert Lloyd and Myrtle Madge Crozier Scholarship. Congratulations, Emmett. The Mabel Urban and Alice Rowley Scholarship goes to Benjamin Vanicky. Ben is also being awarded a Knoxville Alumni Association in memory of Will Prather Scholarship, a Beatty Tucker American Legion Scholarship, a First United Methodist Church Scholarship, a Knoxville Rotary Club Scholarship, and a Powell Electric Cooperative Scholarship. Congratulations. The Marion County Title Services Scholarship is awarded to Brett Snyder. Congratulations, Brett. Abigail Wadley is being presented the Class of 1991 Scholarship. Abby is also being presented the following scholarships: Beatty Tucker American Legion Scholarship, the Robert Lloyd and Myrtle Madge Crozier Scholarship, and a Knoxville Rotary Club Scholarship. Congratulations, Abby. Peyton Brayman is presented the Winfield Funeral Home Scholarship. Congratulations, Peyton. Jasper Lynn McGrath is being presented the Emery and Darlene Risley Family Scholarship. The Freund Family Scholarship is awarded to John Butel. John is also the recipient of the Robert Lloyd and Myrtle Madge Crozier Scholarship, the Knoxville Rotary Club Scholarship, a People's Bank Scholarship, St. Anthony's Catholic Church Scholarship, and a Knights of Columbus Scholarship. Congratulations, John. The Knoxville Booster Club Scholarship is awarded to Reese Wignall. Reese is also the recipient of the Andy Popson Memorial Scholarship and a Knoxville High School Music Booster Scholarship. Congratulations, Reese. The Mentor Study Club Scholarship is awarded to Anna Fay. Anna is also the recipient of the following scholarships: the Knoxville Rotary Club Leela Clark Scholarship and the St. Anthony Catholic Church Scholarship, along with the Knights of Columbus Scholarship. Congratulations. The Mike and Betty Cunningham Scholarship and a Knoxville Rotary Club Scholarship is awarded to Isabella Gaysert. Dexter DeGuey is being presented with the Knoxville Panther Scholarship Foundation Honors Scholarship. And again, Dexter was unable to be here this evening, but we want to congratulate Dexter. The Class of 1964 Scholarship is awarded to Claire Schneider. Recipient of the Gene Edwards Memorial Scholarship, a PEO Chapter LW Local SPAR Scholarship, and Knoxville Rotary Club Scholarship. Congratulations, Claire. The Class of 1966 Scholarship and the Community First Credit Union Scholarship is awarded to Delaney Martin. Congratulations, Delaney. Angelina DeSocio is presented the Don and Margaret Long Scholarship, along with the Knoxville Education Association Scholarship, a Knoxville Elementary Schools PTO Scholarship, and a Knoxville Rotary Club Scholarship. Congratulations, Angelina. Catherine Sims and Dale Rankin Scholarship is presented to Max Purvis. Max is also receiving the First United Methodist Church Scholarship. Congratulations, Max. The Bill Leakey Scholarship is awarded to Ishmael Sinitsia. Congratulations, Max. Scholarship Foundation Honor Scholarship is awarded to Kylie McCall. Robert Sloan is being presented the Jim Darnell Scholarship. The Edward Jones Investment Scholarship goes to Brianna Wood. Brianna was unable to attend this evening. Layla Tiller is being presented the Cunningham Financial Services Scholarship. Frida Barlow Memorial Scholarship is presented to Gracie Smith. Walker Memorial Scholarship is awarded to Alexander O'Neill. Alex is also receiving a Knoxville Alumni Association Class of 1964 in memory of Jane Walter Bowsman Scholarship. Congratulations, Alex. Austin Porniga is awarded the Cushman Excavation Scholarship. Congratulations. Taylor Bacorn is awarded the Class of 1973 Scholarship. A Knoxville Raceway Scholarship is being awarded to Charlie Heffern. Charlie is also a of the Knoxville Alumni Association in memory of Joanne Lee Scholarship and a PEO Chapter M Scholarship. Congratulations, Charlie. Kinsey Kincaid is presented a Knoxville Raceway Scholarship, and in addition, Kinsey is also being awarded a Rotary Club Scholarship. Congratulations. Tristan Bacorn is awarded the Raceway Tire and Exhaust Scholarship. The M. Virginia Onsteck Memorial Scholarship is being presented to Danielle Johnston. Danielle's also receiving a Knoxville High School Music Booster Scholarship, a Knoxville Optimist Club Scholarship, and the Todd Edwards Memorial Scholarship. Congratulations, Danielle. The Dorsey Andrews Masonic Lodge Scholarship is being awarded to Liliana Mejia. The Susan Scott Memorial Scholarship is presented to Brock Benner. Brock is also being awarded the Gladys Black Memorial Scholarship and the Red Rock Environmental Education Foundation Scholarship. Congratulations, Brock. A Knoxville Raceway Scholarship is being awarded to Danielle Maddox. Danielle is also receiving a Knoxville Optimist Club Scholarship. Congratulations. Sean Collins is the recipient of the Bill Leakey Scholarship. Sean is also receiving the Cadmus Family Scholarship, the Todd Myers Memorial Scholarship, the Baby Tucker American Legion Scholarship, a Knoxville Optimist Club Scholarship, and a Knoxville Rotary Club Leela Hart Scholarship. Congratulations. The Pleasant and Marjorie Feast Scholarship and a Rotary Club Scholarship goes to Hallie McRoberts. The Knoxville Hospital and Clinic Scholarship is awarded to Brooke Moore. Brooke is also being awarded a Knoxville Optimist Club Scholarship. Congratulations, Brooke. Appella Rolls Screen Foundation Scholarship is presented to Ellie Enzer. Brandon Barkey is being presented the Class of 1984 Scholarship. Brandon is also receiving a Knoxville Education Foundation Scholarship. Congratulations, Brandon. The Knoxville Vet Clinic Scholarship is awarded to Leah Watson. He has also awarded the Beatty Tucker American Legion Scholarship and the John Myers VFW and VFW Auxiliary Scholarship. Alexa Jerkins is being presented the Don and Margaret Long Scholarship. Alexa is also receiving the Alpha Kappa Grant and Aid Scholarship, a Knoxville Education Association Scholarship, and a Stepping Stone Scholarship. Congratulations, Alexa. A Knoxville Panther Scholarship Foundation Honor Scholarship goes to Peyton C. Peyton could not be with us this year. Tyler Kearney is being presented the Jana Dennison Memorial Scholarship. Tyler is also receiving the Robert Lloyd and Myrtle Madge Crozier Scholarship and an Knoxville Rotary Club Scholarship. Congratulations, Tyler. Jordan Schwartzman-Druber is being presented an Knoxville Raceway Scholarship. Jordan is also receiving a Beatty Tucker American Legion Scholarship and a Knoxville Rotary Club Scholarship. The Bybee Davis Funeral Home Scholarship goes to Hayden Lee. Our final scholarships tonight are awarded to Chris Amasta. Krista is awarded the Steve DeMoss Memorial Scholarship and the Andy Popson Memorial Scholarship. Congratulations. This concludes tonight's presentation of scholarships. I want to thank all of our donors for providing over $80,000 in scholarships to the graduating class of 2022. Thank you very much for your support. Let's give our donors another round of applause. Would also remind you that there are cupcakes out there on your way out, and also seniors, you need to stay for a picture, but I do want to take one last moment to invite all of you to Senior Awards Assembly. which is in the gym at 9 a.m. on Friday, May 20th, and graduation, which is Sunday, May 22nd, at 2 o'clock in the gym. Thank you very much, and congratulations to all of our scholarship